Hi everybody. So got the red basics in for the poinsettia flowers. So don't be alarmed when you see it. It'll get better, honest. I'm going to just alter the camera now and get a bit closer so you can see what I'm doing. I thought I might make it a bit light around there. I might still, but I do like the intensity of this, so maybe not. The thing is, you just have to do what you think and then, do what you fancy seeing, and then just, if it doesn't look bright, just change it. Okay, so I'm just going to do this with my finger. For me, but this is my best smudging tool, something like this. I've actually, I've done this with the pencil in these streaks here, just to fill them in. But of course, I can still put more white over the top of that. I'll do this side as well. So, where were we? We're just putting in this. We'll put a bit more red in here. So I mixed two reds for this and tried to merge them through, as you can probably see there. It's a little bit there, but you won't even notice that once we get all the colour on it. Kind of roundness to the tips of these poinsettias. Let's get my brown again. Now, you'll see where we are now. We've got that. Yeah, there's a lot more darkness in there. You see that? Just there. Smudgy darkness there. This is extremely soft touch I'm using here. Very, very soft. We don't want lines on here, we just want a bit of shading, that's all. And under here, put a little bit of shading. We need to make that nice and spiky there. Which we've already done. A bit of shading under here. See, the more you look at this, the more you can see in it. I'm now seeing this. And darkness coming around there. And then that's kind of coming around that way. And then there's another dark patch coming through here. To a point just here. This is coming around here. This is darker through here, but not as dark as this. And there's some streaks coming up here. That's done already. There's that. That's about coming out like that. It's all very soft, isn't it, almost? Okay, so we've got all the red bits in. Got some streaky bits coming through here. Put a bit more of the orange right under that as well. Dark green, I think, and try and do some of these bits here. See, we've got that, it's coming. This is a very dark green. Strong pigment because it's the Caran d'Ache. So this is just like, it's coming in a line, isn't it? We've got a line coming right round here, about here. It's kind of curved, like that. Then there's a lovely bit of green here, just here. Just come in. It's coming about there, yeah. Spikes across here. And then we've got our, see, I've changed this a bit here, but it doesn't matter. I'll just busk it a bit. And then we've got a green bit coming through here. Now this is quite green here. Kind of like this really, isn't it? Quite close to the little bauble. Just put that through there. And then there's another bit coming. Yeah, through here. Looking where it is on this bauble here. It's coming quite low. And then it's got another streak coming through here. That one like that. And then we've got a little bit here where it goes into a little curl. I'll leave a bit going over the bauble because we need to make that look like a bauble first. These are very like a feather actually, aren't they? Very similar. This is coming here. That's where the green starts. There's all green under there. I'll put a bit of a light, more cheery green on there. Let's just get the dark marks in. That really helps me actually. If you get the dark marks in, it's really very good. Gives you a bit more. There's some dark. I've got some dark marks in here. This is very like doing whiskers actually, but you don't get green whiskers, of course. That's about right there. And there's a good mark here. Now to get this to look really furry, you've really got to pay attention to where these bits are coming out. We'll do that green under there first, I think. But we'll just put the darker marks in here. It's coming up here. And we've got some dark marks there. there's quite a strong line there, so we'll put that in. Just put it in lightly. Now, we've got to try and make these look as round as possible. Just try and get this roundness in here. I've done it very, very faintly at the moment. Now what we can do is when we get, it's gone slightly wonky, you can just sort of fill it out again. Get that real good circle, because you can see there's quite a light line there. Get it in. That'll really help. And we'll kind of smudge this over a bit and put some more fur in there, something like that. Well, let's just do it like this. Could be another bit of fur coming up there, couldn't it? And then we can kind of get away with that there a bit. That's going to be all green. And we'll put some more green under here. Just lighten this off a little bit here. And then when we get all the corally stuff over there, you won't even see that. I hope. Okay, so that's okay for there. And we've got a mass of the corally colour through here. And we've got a bit more green here. I think it looks quite nice with a bit of something going on here. And I have kind of penciled it in there. I think I'll move this and put it up here where the bauble is really. I don't really want it down here. So I'm just gonna copy that, put it up here where the bauble is, I think. Be about the top of it there. So we'll do that with another colour. And then we can put the green over it. That look okay, I think. So for now, we're just gonna get all these parts going that way, just to give us an idea of how it should go. We'll do this bit here. If I can get my brown going, because this should be brown in here as well. And then you can fill in this bit here with the orange salmon-y colour. That's very nice. Do these brown as well. Nice green coming through there. Just slightly comes off there. And then you've got a little mark coming there. So can we get little bits here? This is our line here. That's the bourbon line. Just to give us a bit of a guide. I put it in so faintly you can barely see it. But it gives a bit of a guide. Very gently here. And I think I will, I'll just put a little bit of a shadow effect under there. Got some darkness there. I think the red needs to go in there first. So I'll put the dark, put the really deep red in there. Red coming through here. I'll leave that a little bit light in there because that's where we've got a lot of fur. We can use that lightness there. Put a bit of the orangey red over there. See, and it's coming round. Crossing over there. And that's going up there. And then we've got the dark, got some light marks. It's very dark and bitty on the end here. It's the same as fur, looking at the direction. This is fur. Tree fur, of course. Making sure my pencil. shape. It needs to be just kind of over the front of his ear. I haven't got that right there. That needs to be like that. Got a bit more orange. Nice to have.